Hi students, have a nice morning. In this video, we are going to see our fourth poem, The Ant and the Cricket, adapted from Aesop's Fables. Okay. So let us see about the author. Aesop. Okay, so the name of the author is Aesop. So, Aesop's Fables, the fables written by Aesop is called as Aesop's Fables, right? So, what is mean by fables is, a fable is a short story. Okay, it is a fable is a short story. It is a short story typically about the animal's characters. Okay, so there will be mostly animal character in this story. It is called as fable. Okay, so a fable is a short story mostly with the animal characters. Okay, what is Aesop's fable is? The fables written by Aesop is called as Aesop's fables. So, Aesop's fables is a collection of fables credited to Aesop, a slave and a storyteller believed to have lived in ancient Greek between 620 and 564 BCE, before Christian era. Okay, so it is a collection of fables credited to Aesop. So it is believed that Aesop had written this fables. A slave. So who is Aesop? He is a slave. Okay, and a storyteller, and also he was a storyteller, believed to have lived in ancient Greece between 620 and 564 BCE. So no one has seen him. We have a belief that he had lived in the ancient Greek period, that is old. And so ancient means old, so old Greek period between 620 and 564 BCE. BCE means before Christian era, that is period. These fables became popular when they emerged in print. It means when these fables were printed as books, they became very popular. Several stories are attributed to Aesop even today. Okay, so even today, many stories are believed to be written by Aesop. The process of inclusion is continuous and new stories are being added. Okay, inclusion means adding new stories. Okay, adding new stories is called as inclusion. So, the process of inclusion is continuous and new stories are being added to. Added to what? Added to Aesop's fables. Collections of Aesop's fables were among the earliest books to be printed in many languages. Okay, so collection of Aesop's fable were among the, so the collection of Aesop fable. Okay, it is the earliest book which was printed in many languages. Okay, so simply Aesop is believed to be a slave and a storyteller who lived in the ancient Greek period between 620 and 564 BCE. So the fables believed to be told by him were collected under the Aesop's fables. Right. Now let us go into the poem. See, here they have given about fable. So a fable is a traditional. Traditional means cultural or old. Okay, story that teaches us a moral lesson. So it will teach us a moral. Usually the characters in the fables are animals. So as I told you already, so usually the characters in the fables are animals. This poem, The Ant and the Cricket, teaches us the importance of hard work and planning. So in this poem, The Ant and the Cricket, what is the moral of the poem Ant and the Cricket is? It teaches us, it tells us, informs us about the hard work, importance of hard work and planning. Let us go into the poem. So this poem consists of 8 stanzas. Okay, so in this class we are going to see the first 4 stanzas, right? Let me read it once. A silly young cricket accustomed to sing through the warm, sunny months of gay summer and spring, began to complain when he found that at home his cupboard was empty and winter was come. Not a crumb to be found on the snow-covered ground, not a flower could he see, not a leaf on a tree. How, what'll become, says Cricket, of me? At last, by starvation and famine, made bold, all dripping with wet and all trembling with cold, away he set off to a miserly ant to see if, to keep him alive, he would grant him shelter from rain and a mouthful of grain. He wished only to borrow, he would repay it tomorrow. If not, he must die of starvation and sorrow. Okay, now let us see about the poem. So, a silly young cricket, accustomed to sing through the warm sunny months of gay summer and spring. Okay, so what is cricket? See, they have given here. So, cricket, a brown or black insect related to a grasshopper but with shorter legs. It is a small insect that produces short, loud sounds by rubbing its wings together. So, you might have seen this insect in our home itself. Okay. So, it will be making a little creaky sound. So, it is a brown or black colored insect which belongs to the grasshopper family. But this grasshopper has long legs, but this has shorter legs. It is a small insect which produces short, loud sounds by rubbing its wings together. So, that sound is made when it is rubbing its wings together. That is cricket. Okay. Now, let us see the first answer. So, a silly young cricket. So, what is the nature of this cricket is? It is silly. It is always playful. It will not do any of its work properly. Okay, it will be always behaving in a silly manner, naughty manner. Okay, a silly young cricket accustomed to sing. Okay, accustomed means it used to sing through the warm, sunny months of gay summer. Gay means happy, glad. Okay, glad. And spring. Okay, so listen. So, what it used to do is, it used to sing happily through the summer months. So, usually, what is the nature of the insect is, all the insects will collect its food during the summer season. Okay, ant paathirupolaya. So, what it will do? It will collect its food during the summer season and it will keep safe in its house. Adoda house la adu romba safe a vechukum because during the rainy season it cannot get any food. But these cricket, what it used to do is, it always used to sing very happily through the summer. Okay, so its nature is singing. It will be singing always very happily. It is just enjoying its life very happily during the summer and the spring. Begin to complain when he found that. So, it will start to complain when it finds that at home. Whose home? In the cricket's home. At home, his cupboard was empty and winter was come. Okay. So, it will start to complain. When it will start to complain is when it finds that in its home the cupboard was empty. Which cupboard? The cupboard in which it used to store food. Okay, so when it finds that there is no food in its cupboard, it will start to complain. Okay, and winter was come. And by this time what will happen? Winter season will come. So during the winter season, the insects cannot find any food. Okay, this is what said in the first stanza. It is simple. So, yeah, there is a cricket. It is silly by nature. So, it used to sing happily, enjoy its life during the summer and the spring season. And what will happen is, it will start to complain when there is no food in its cupboard. When it finds its cupboard empty, it will start to complain. And by that time, what will come? Winter season will come. Okay, let us see the second stanza. Not a crumb to be found on the snow-covered ground. Not a flower could he see, not a leaf on a tree. Okay, not a crumb to be found. Crumb means a piece of bread. Okay, or a piece of food, little piece, a small piece. So, during the winter season, what happens? It cannot find even a small little piece of food on the snow-covered ground, because as it is the winter season, the ground is entirely covered with the snow. So during the snow winter season, the ground is entirely snow-covered and it cannot find even a single piece of or a little piece of food on the ground, snow-covered ground, since it is winter season. Not a flower could he see, so it cannot see even a flower. Not a leaf on a tree, so the tree is empty. It cannot see any flowers and leaf on the tree, and it cannot see any single piece of food on the ground. How, what will become of me, says Cricket. At last, by starvation and famine, made bold, all dripping with wet and all trembling with the cold, away he set off to a miserly ant to see if to keep him alive he would grant. Okay, so what happened is, oh, what will become of me, says Cricket. So the cricket starts worrying, okay, and it is worried that what will happen to me, says Cricket, because there is no food in its cupboard and it cannot, winter season has started and it cannot find any food even on the ground. So it started to worry, what will become of me? At last, by starvation and famine, made bold. Okay, starvation means hungry. Okay, feeling of hungry. Famine means scarcity for food. Okay, so lack of food, scarcity for food. At last, by starvation and famine, made bold, all dripping with wet and all trembling with cold. So dripping with wet means completely it is wet. Why? Because it is soaked. Soaked na inna full nananju poyidrathu. Okay, all dripping with wet and trembling with cold. Trembling means shivering. Okay, and all shivering with cold. So what happened? It started to worry, what will happen to me, what will become of me. And at last, what it had decided, it became very bold because of starvation and famine, because of hungry and lack of food, scarcity of food. It became very bold and it was completely wet and shivering with the cold. Why? Because it is a winter season. Away he set off to a miserly ant. Okay, it started its journey to meet whom? To meet a miserly ant. Miserly na enna? Miser appdin yara solluvom, the person who will not spend a lot. Okay, kanjan nu solluvom illaya, that is called as miser. So miserly ant means the ant is also like that. It will not share its food or anything to anybody else. Okay, but it will keep everything safe for it. So it started to go for a journey to meet a miserly ant to see if to keep him alive he would grant him shelter from rain. Okay, so why it is going to the ant is because to see if to keep him alive. To keep whom alive? To keep the cricket alive. Adu uyiroda irukkaradhukku at least he would grant him shelter from rain. He refers to the ant. Him refers to the cricket. Okay, to keep him alive he would grant him shelter from rain. Okay, at least to keep him alive, whether it will grant him shelter from the rain and a mouthful of grain. Okay, and also whether it will give or share any mouthful of grain. Okay, whether it will share some food and whether it will share some shelter. He wished only to borrow. So what is the wish of the cricket is only to borrow. Just it wants to borrow from the ant. Enna borrow pannano? Some grain. Okay, he would repay it tomorrow. So enna pannidom idhukku enough food kedacha odane cricket will pay back the food tomorrow. Okay, If not, he must die of starvation and sorrow. So if it is not borrowing any food, it will die of starvation. So starvation means hungry. Okay, hungry and sorrow. So if it is not going to get any food from the ant, okay, so if it is not going to get any food from the ant, what will happen? The cricket will die of starvation and sorrow. Okay, that's why what it is planning. See, the ant is enjoying its life. Why? Because the ant had saved enough food. That's why it is sleeping, it is enjoying. But what the cricket had done? It used to behave silly. It always used to sing songs and enjoy during the summer season without collecting any food. So it doesn't have any food during the winter season. And that's why it had planned to go and meet the miserly ant to see if to keep him alive he would grant him shelter from rain. Whether it will grant means permit or give. Okay, so it will grant, permit some shelter from rain and some mouthful of grain. So it just wanted to borrow. Kadana tha vaangudhu edhu cricket, because it will be repaying it tomorrow. So if it is not going and borrowing this from the ant, what will happen? It will die of starvation and hunger. So it will die, sorry, sorrow. It will die of hungry and sorrow. Okay, so this is what we have seen today. Let us continue the remaining in the next class. Okay. I hope everyone of you have understood. Thank you for watching. Thank you.